Guys, medyo pa-girl tayo ngayon. Medyo naka-pink, tapos... We have to go through the fire. Through the fire! Oh my gosh, this vlog is so makalat. I'm sorry. Hi everyone! Welcome back to Stories with Pao. Ang taas na energy! Woo! Kailangan mataas energy natin because this is the last episode of the Lead Life series. For those who have been watching the previous episodes of this series, Lead Life, thank you very much. And I hope, syempre naman, may nakukuha kayong value, no? Kasi if wala, ano pang saisay na itong ginagawa natin? So the title of this episode is Lead Life, You Can Be More. Fighting! If napag-usapan na natin sa first episode yung finding your purpose and then thinking big, diba? Thinking like a millionaire. So ngayon naman, we will also be basing our last episode sa isa na namang book. Ta-da! It's Grit by Angela Duckworth. Grabe guys, super good read nito. For those na talagang maraming pinagdadaanan sa buhay, hindi po to love life book ah. This is how to be gritty nga and go through challenges in life. So doon natin ibibase ang ating topic for tonight. So the title of it nga is Grit. Pero let's define grit first. So grit means passion plus perseverance, okay? Ano ba meaning nun? Charot. So yeah, well, passion naman, self-explanatory na yun, di ba? What are you passionate about in life? So, kung ano yung gusto mo talagang gawin, it's basically your purpose din, di ba? So, if hindi mo pa alam what your purpose is, panoorin mo muna yung first episode ko, Why Are You Here? And then, perseverance, in Tagalog, pagpupursige. Diba? Yun yung meaning ng perseverance. So, if you match those two up, you get grit. Okay? So, another term for grit then is yung never give up attitude. Kapag may sinimulan ako, I will finish that race. Oo. So, kahit sa love life pa yan. Kaya, yeah. I can relate to that kasi yung relationships ko din before long term eh. Except for the last one. But... once you start something, you have to finish it. Paano ba nagkakaroon ng grit yung isang person? So, people develop grit through trials. So, totoo yan. Basically, yun eh. Dun mo talaga malalaman kung matibay ka talaga is after every challenge eh. How you handle the situations, how you get back up on your feet, diba? Or kung gaano ka ba katagal nagdedwell dun sa situation, sa problem, diba? So, yung mga people who are gritty, syempre, madadown din naman yan. Tao lang, diba? But, they choose to get back up faster than those who are not so gritty. So, ito, sabi din sa book, some people are great when things are going well, but fall apart when things aren't. Okay? So, syempre, kapag masaya ang buhay, syempre, masaya, di ba, when everything is going well nga. Pero, dun mo matitest yung pagiging gritty mo when you're in challenges eh, di ba? In anything naman, di ba, not just in career, but yun nga, for example, sa love life, parang yung test of commitment din sa partner mo, makikita mo when you guys are in a rocky road, di ba, when you guys are going through challenges. Instead dun sa happy moments. Kasi madali lang naman to course through the happy moments eh. Mag-enjoy ka lang, di ba? Ito pa sabi, determination is not enough. You have to have direction. Oh, di ba? Very deep. it's not enough na you're a hardworking person eh. So yun nga, kaya nga sa first episode ng series na to, we talk more on finding your why muna, diba? Finding your purpose. Kasi when you know your why, when you know your goal, you have a direction eh. When you have a direction, that's good, pero syempre, determination and hard work will get you there. Okay? And then, sabi din, talent does not guarantee grit. Oh, so I'd like to ponder on this. So, usually kasi, usually yan sa pag-iisip ng tao eh, na parang, kunyari, si ganyan naging successful, di ba? Naging milyonaryo. Iisipin na, ay, magaling kasi naman talaga yan eh. Talented naman talaga yan eh, ganyan. Sure ba na puro talent lang? Of course not. Kasi especially yun nga, business people. Business is really hard, guys. I just like to say, kasi yun nga, I also do business. So, it's really hard. So, it's not purely talent. Actually, ako wala nga akong background in doing businesses. So, the business that I'm in now is the first business venture that I got into. Okay. And ayun, it's really a progress of learning, of growing yourself, not just as a business person, but as an individual as well. So, alisin na rin natin yung ganung mindset na yun nga, when we judge people, di ba, who are successful, ah, kasi mayaman naman na talaga yan, or matalino, or talented, ganyan. We don't know. Yun una, di ba? We don't know, kasi we don't know their full story naman. We're just seeing like a portion of that, di ba? So, yeah. It's ano talaga. It's all hard work talaga. And speaking of that, so sabi here, effort counts twice, okay? When we overemphasize talent, we underemphasize everything else. Greatness is doable. If you're talented, that's good, you have an advantage. But if you won't parang hone or enhance your skills pa, your talent will mean nothing. Kasi talent yun nga, talent won't get you to your destination eh. It's how you will work for it. Sa relationship as well. So, for example, ano ka? Syempre, sa una, magagaling naman kayo, di ba? Smooth talker. You express your feelings well. Ganyan. So, syempre, yun yung parang talent. Yun yung talent nyo to be with someone para maging kayo, di ba? To spark up the romance. But, you know, if you want to like be in a long-term relationship, it's gonna take more than that, diba? It's gonna take more work as you get to know the person more. You will learn how to commit more, to adjust yourself, ganyan. So, same thing goes when you are aiming for something. Kailangan eh. Wala talagang ano, guys. Wala talagang madali. So, lahat talaga in life, tinatrabaho. Especially, yung pangarap mo. Effort builds skill. So, tama, diba? If you want to master something, you can't master it without practicing eh. Or without doing it again and again until you master it. Yun, hindi naman siya one hit wonder lagi. Yun na? Parang, it doesn't make sense. So, kailangan talaga may puso, may dugo, may pawis. Na daw? Grit grows. To do anything really well, you have to overextend yourself. Okay, tama, diba? For example, gusto nyo matutong mag-paint, diba? Kanyari, ganyan. Gusto nyo maging Picasso, ganyan. Hindi pwedeng once a year ka lang magpa-practice mag-paint, 'di ba? Diba yung mga ano, K-pop idol, 'di ba? BTS, woo, BTS fan ako. Nagpa-practice talaga every single day sila, like ng dance choreography, writing their songs, every single day talaga they do it. They overextend themselves to master their craft. And it's really beautiful, 'di ba? When people go through that, when they really overextend themselves, when they really have a clear vision, diba, of what they want. It's really beautiful kasi kita na we are capable of creating magic eh. Wow. That's the power of people, diba? When we want something, we can make it happen, diba? And kaya naman talaga siya. As we grow older, we are thrust into new situations. And then we rise to the occasion, we change when we need to. Very much true, especially of adulting life. So, tapos na tayo sa, aasa tayo sa parents natin, diba? To give us food, to buy us things, guide us sa mga direction, sa labas, diba? Hindi na, adulting talaga, ikaw lahat! Ikaw mag-figure out lahat. Well, I'm not saying naman na we can't ask our parents na or yung mga nakakatanda. Of course, we can. And that's also important, seeking for feedback. But really, how to navigate in your life, how to really succeed and get to the success you want, ikaw lahat yun eh. And that's the beauty of it, actually. Parang, syempre, nung una, ma-overwhelm ka, diba? Sa first job mo, for example, or when you are thrust into the real world, rejection happens, heartbreak happens, disappointment happens, diba? Syempre, mabibigla ka. Parang, oh, ano ba nangyayari? My world is ending. Ay, arte. Talagang, mapupush ka to adjust, to mature, diba? To be more patient, diba? And that's how we grow din talaga. To be the best versions of ourselves. So, that's okay. God puts us in the most difficult situations. Hindi ko alam yung term yung basta yung sword, diba? Kung gustong para maging maganda talaga yung sword, maging sharp, 'di ba? Maging shiny. Nilalagay siya sa fire, 'di ba? Para ma-mold siya into a perfect weapon. When I was going through challenges, especially lately na yun na nga medyo nagmamature na yung isip ni Pao, I learned to appreciate challenges more. Pero hindi naman ako magpapaka-hypocrite na hindi ako nahihirapan, hindi ako umiiyak. Umiiyak pa rin ako. Iiyakin ako eh. So, I don't see it as something na will end me. Na parang, shucks, ano nang gagawin ko sa buhay ko? Yeah, kasi parang after every challenge, it means na you have to evolve eh. You have to evolve into something new. So, it's something exciting na nga rin for me when I go through challenges na, okay, sige, ano na kaya magiging ano ko after this, 'di ba? And dito rin kasi we are already living in a world of instant gratification, 'di ba? Na instant noodles, instant shopping, 'di ba? Instant jowa na talagang swipe swipe swipe, 'di ba? Na experience ko 'yan, I'm not saying it's anything bad, but yun nga, we're in a world na everything is available to us in the internet. So, it's really difficult then to stay gritty. Kasi, yun nga, grit takes effort, hard work talaga, commitment, di ba? Kaya parang minsan, a lot of people, kunyari, hindi na umukay sa job nila na ganito, lipat na ulit doon, parang pa-jump-jump na lang. Pero, that's okay, kasi that's how you will know din naman talaga what you want, eh. But, yeah, ako kasi, I'm the kind of person na when I really finally decide what I want to pursue in life, yun eh. Parang, dun na talaga nakatingin yung, dun na naka-direct yung focus ko eh. And it's logical din naman, diba? Kasi, you have to go in a straight line eh. Para mabilis yung success mo, diba? Kasi if you're going in a scribble, diba? Syempre paliku-liko, it's gonna take more time. When you are really pursuing something, especially if it's something big and it's something out of the ordinary, mahirap talaga. Okay? It's gonna be difficult talaga. Extra difficult pa siya, actually. If you are really gunning for a big dream, diba? Pero that doesn't mean naman na that dream is impossible. Diba? It's not. It's just the bigger the dream, the bigger the resistance kasi. But it's still doable, diba? You can still achieve that. You can still be more. You can achieve that kind of life that you want, diba? You have to grow, eh. you have to really stick to it. Una, you have to be firm about it. You have to accept na it's going to be difficult. And third, you have to grow yourself, which is the hardest, diba? Hindi talaga pwedeng hindi ka open to feedback, na mabilis kang ma-down, mabilis kang ma-disheartened through challenges talaga. Hindi pwede yun eh, kasi yun, that's the reality of life. Mahirap talaga ang buhay, diba? Mahirap talaga, but you really have to find for the positive things to really keep you going. And yung parang kahit mahirap, your why is worth enough. At the end of the finish line, ito naman yung makukuha mo, diba? It's hard to see the future. It's hard to depend on something din talaga na you don't see happening yet. But that's the purpose of faith, diba? So, yun din. Ako din kasi I really hold on to my faith now. And I really trust my father na he didn't show this path to me just to show it to me. He showed it to me because he knows na I can go through with it. So if you're in a situation now of or if you have an opportunity na nagpresent sa inyo but you're really scared to take it or take the risk kasi it's something new out of your comfort zone, guys, go for it, okay? Especially if it's out of your comfort zone kasi that's where you're gonna grow. You really have to pray. Because that's how you're gonna be guided and how you're gonna be aligned with the things that you're doing now. You have to seek for confirmation as well from our dad, diba? So, yeah, basically, that's it! So, that's the end of our series. This time, Lead Life. So, I really hope na you got a lot of value and I was able to give a little helping hand for you to lead your life better. Ganon, okay? Have to take charge, guys, kasi no one will do it for us. It's just us, diba? So, yeah, if you like this content, I'll be posting more. I post every week, every Friday. So, feel free to like and subscribe in my YouTube channel. I hope you had a great night tonight. So, bye-bye! See you next week! Mwah.